Hi, Draftaholics. Welcome to our guide to standard for Nationals 2018. I'm Richard. I'm here with Julian. How are you going?
How are you doing?
We're going to talk about a deck that we might see at Nationals. It's been around for a while, the red deck. How does this deck work?
So, Mono Red is a very traditional archetype. It is the quintessential aggro deck. You play a bunch of creatures on curve, you cast removal and things get in the way, and you can use them to finish off your opponent.
So we've got a lot of these creatures have been around for a while. You've got your Bomat Courier, Soulscar Mage, etc. What new things are there in this version of the deck?
Well, the only new card in the main deck is Viashino Pyromancer. So it works very well with Flame of Keld, and it's just a good card in general. So in week one, you want to be more aggressive. You play more one drops. The first part of Flame of Keld becomes less of a disadvantage. And then, you know, the third saga combined with Pyromancer can deal, you know, 4 damage to your opponent in addition to your burn spells.
Double everything up.
Yep.
And of course, there's the bane of standard, the Chainwhirler.
Yeah, there was a lot of talk about whether Chainwhirler would get banned, but it didn't. And we just have to live with that. So, you know, it's going to go in every deck that can cast it reliably.
Okay, there are many things you could put in the sideboard of a red deck. We've chosen some here. There's a whole lot of big pool you could choose from, but what do these things do for you in the sideboard?
Well, the first three cards have been around for a while. You know, Chandra's Defeat, Harvester, both in the mirror, a break just to kill whatever needs killing. But we do have two new cards, Guttersnipe and Banefire. Banefire is a bit easier to understand. You know, it deals damage. It's good against control decks, which are rampy with Settle the Wreckage, and it kind of replaces Fight Fire with Fire because the Can't Be Counter clause is very important. Guttersnipe is a bit trickier to evaluate, but there are a lot of matchups where the board gets clustered up. So what you do is you just cast all your removal, kill all the creatures, but because you've Guttersnipe out, in the process of killing your opponent's creatures, you actually kill them as well.
It's got a little bit yeah. Extra value you get from that.
Yeah.
All right, so there's the mono red deck, but you can also add a few other colors, and this is a deck we've seen in the previous format as well, the red black deck. What do we get from adding black?
Well, you add your black and you still play a lot of the same creatures that you had in the mono red deck, so Bomat Courier, Hazoret, Chainwhirler, etc. But adding black gives you access to two very important cards, the first being Scrapheap Scratcher. A lot of the times it's going to be generic 2-drop 5-8. But the line of text where it lets you to bring it back from your graveyard, that's very important in grindy matchups or any matchup with a lot of removal. The second card is Unlicensed Disintegration. This is important because it just lets you kill more things and just gives you a bit more reach. You know, we're only playing 2 copies here, but if you had 4, then your opponent essentially starts at 17 every game.
And they're working together, yep. Giving you the 3 damage when you've got your Scrounger around.
Absolutely.
There's also a Cut to Ribbons over there. It's just one of. What's that doing for you?
Well, the Cut to Ribbons, the first half is good enough by itself. You know, 2 mana, deal 4, gets rid of 4 toughest creatures such as a Steelleaf Champion. The second half just kind of gives you a bit more reach, but, you know, just the cut by itself is already very impressive.
Okay, and in the black version of the deck, we've obviously got more cards to choose from for our sideboard. So what do you get with the inclusion of black?
Well, your sideboard, a lot of it's just cards that we saw in the mono red deck. So, you know, Chandra's Defeat, Abrade, you know, Glorybringer, which we didn't see previously, but it's good against, you know, big creatures. But the main thing that black gives you is discard. So you have 4 Duress and 2 Doomfall. 6 discard effects are very good against control, and Doomfall doubles up as removal against a sneaky Liar that they might bring in.
So look at this Angrath in here. When are you bringing in Angrath?
Angrath kind of sticks out like a sore thumb, but you know, because you slow down compared to the mono red decks, you have a bit more trouble with control. So Angrath just kind of, you know, patches up your win percentage a little bit.
Excellent. All right, that's the red and the red black decks. Thanks a lot for telling us how they work, Julian.
Happy to be here.
And everyone, if you want to kill people fast, you're aggressive, and you want to win and burn people's face, I think you should choose one of these decks for Nationals. Good luck.